Hey everyone, this is the Canadian Lad, and in this video, I'm gonna give you the 5 reasons behind Thanos being able to break Captain America's shield in Avengers Endgame. Stick around and hopefully by the end of this video, you won't be confused anymore about how Thanos destroyed the indestructible. So without any further ado, let's begin. Number 1. The vibranium is not indestructible. It is the strongest metal ever known to men and men only. But Thanos is not from around here. Neither is his weapon. Thanos is very smart and has access to extremely advanced technology. With Ebony Maw's help, for example, he was able to reverse engineer and mass produce pim particles from a single sample. It is evident that he made or found a material which is harder and more durable than vibranium and made a blade with it, meaning that his sword can cut Cap's shield. Number 2. In the final battle when Thor and Iron Man were both terribly hit, Captain America became the only one defending against Thanos. Remember, Captain America by the time had already made Thanos very angry by hurting him with Mjolnir and Thunder. That made Thanos incredibly angry. Notice how Thanos was fighting with just his right hand in the entire battle, but when he got angry, he took off his helmet of armor and started attacking Cap using both of his hands. He went crazy over here, using his double-bladed sword with absolutely no mercy. Imagine Thanos striking the shield with the weapon not using one but both his hands, not once but repeatedly. And that's why it wasn't difficult for Thanos to pull this off. Number 3. Vibranium gives the shield an ability to absorb a lot of direct blunt force and deflect the absorbed energy, just like Black Panther's suit, which is also entirely made out of vibranium. Like a normal shield from medieval ages, this shield is most effective at its center, where if it gets struck, the force is distributed throughout the shield equally. But this didn't happen in case of Thanos. When Thanos began to strike Cap's shield with his sword, he didn't aim or hit the center. In fact, his sword was striking at a vertical angle to the edge of the shield, and hence the absorbing by the shield was less effective. Number 4. In Age of Ultron, Ultron Prime's body gets coated in vibranium after he steals some from Claw. Yet in the climactic battle, we see his vibranium body starting to melt from the combined energy of Thor's lightning, Iron Man's Unibeam, and Vision's Mindstone. So vibranium is not indestructible by any means. It's the strongest metal on Earth, making it incredibly difficult to damage, but it can be melted or broken. Number 5. Thanos' blade is most likely made of Uru metal, the strongest metal in the galaxy, at least in the MCU. Vibranium is strong. Yes, there's no denying that. It's the strongest metal on Earth. Keyword here is Earth. It came to Wakanda as a meteorite, so nobody really knows where it came from. But comparing an Uru sword to a vibranium shield is like comparing a titanium sword to an aluminum shield. Now you're probably wondering, but Thor's hammer is made of Uru too. And in Avengers 1 and Age of Ultron, Cap's shield is struck by Mjolnir and nothing happens to the shield. This is simply because Thor's hammer is a blunt object that is made for smashing things in. Thor's new weapon, however, Stormbreaker, which is an axe, is made for splitting things in too. We never see Stormbreaker hitting Cap's shield. This is most likely because it would break the shield, and the Russo brothers know this. And that's why they never teased the idea of combining Stormbreaker with Cap's shield. So there you go, you have the top 5 reasons of Thanos being able to break and damage one of the strongest metals on Earth. But just like Captain America, even I was shocked when I saw it happening for the first time. I just wasn't expecting the foreshadowing of the broken shield from Age of Ultron would actually come true in Avengers Endgame, but it did. Now if you like this video, please grab the subscribe button and give me a thumbs up to keep supporting me grow this channel bigger. I'll see you lads in the next one.